watching WFTDA.tv.
Gatekeepers.
Bell Star, Rose City Rollers,
Erkin Martin, Denver Roller Dolls,
Gemmy Mission, Atlanta Roller Girls,
Meow Mix, Jacksonville Roller Girls,
Kiki Your Ass from Pikes Peak Derby Dames,
Shane Bauer, St. Louis Gatekeepers,
I trust,
I skate,
I am,
Noah Derby.
Sometimes when you play roller derby, you're just kind of like, why am I doing this? This is so weird that I'm essentially have this unpaid second job, which I spend all my first job money to do. And then you go to, you know, you go to playoffs and you go to champs, or you just go to any game and you're like, oh yeah, this is why I do this. My name's Steph Maney. I skate for the Linden Roller Girls, and S1 is part of my uniform.
Good afternoon. Hey. I'm Gretchen the Axe. I'm here with John Maddening. You're watching the 2014 Division II playoffs from Duluth, Minnesota, brought to you by the Harbor City Roller Dames of the Women's Flat Track Derby Association.
All right, next up, we are going to see the Tucson Saddle Tramps take on Suburbia Roller Derby. Tucson, of course, is from Tucson. Easy to find out there. And Suburbia is from Yonkers, New York. Tucson's currently ranked number 53 in the WFTDA rankings, and Suburbia is ranked number 62, both, of course, in Division II, this being the first Division II playoff of the season.
Okay, let's take a moment to talk about the rosters you're going to see today. For Tucson, we have number 010, Shanna Banana Hammock, number 10, Cosmonauti, number 13, Blaxican Bomber, number 24, Midnight Crasher, number 26, Running Heidi, number 3, Pinky McLovin, number 33, Captain Pixie Axe, number 36, Hudson Hornet, number 37, Death Proof, number 4 and 6, Bonita, number 717, Mystery Meat, 86 is Dirty Duchess, 88 is Alabama Whirly, and number 9 is Emasculator.
And over on the side of Suburbia, number 18, Dinosaur Jr., number 19, Angry Penguin, number 23, Barry Boom Boom, number 325, Rogue Pirogue, number 333, Nail Diamond, number 382, Charlotte Bupowski, happy birthday to her, by the way, today. Number 5, Aldynamite, number 50, Lauren Forcer, number 555, Ayayay, number 66, Little Loca, number 78, Brawl Stanley, number 84, Velace Villain, number 89, Tiantini, and number U92, Party Girl Accelerator.
And today's referees for this contest, umpire strikes back is head referee. Harmon Killebrew is inside pack ref. Cruel Hand Luke, jam ref. Z Dork, jam ref. Rage Appropriate is an outside pack ref. High Refinition, outside pack. And Phil Doe, outside pack ref as well. 49 seconds remaining before this one gets underway. Both these teams with tough losses yesterday, John. Tucson almost pulled it out against Big Easy. That last jam just killed him.
Yeah, they're currently ranked number 53 in the WFTD. They've been as low as 77 this year, back in February, so they've been kind of clawing their way up. And, of course, they have been as high in the past as number 2. They came in second in the first ever WFTDA championships back in 2006. Over on Suburbia's side, they are ranked number 62. They've been as low as 74 over the past years, back in April of 2013, and as high as number 55 in March of this year.
And if you have anything you would like to tell us or just be part of the experience, get on Twitter and hit us up at #talk2WFTDA. We are seconds away from roller derby on the Fast Girl Skates line. We have Pixie X for Tucson in black jamming against number 50 Lauren Forcer for Suburbia in red. And we are off. Lauren Forcer up in the front working against a four wall of black skaters again. Tucson in black today. And Pixie X run to the middle. She's going to take a while to reconsider. Now she is back and running in the back. Dinosaur Jr. working her over. Lead jam, meanwhile, up front, picked up by Suburbia. It's number 50, Lauren Forcer.
Lauren Forcer coming up on the back of the pack to make her initial scoring pass. As Pixie X has cleared the pack on her initial pass, Lauren Forcer gets through for all four and calls it off. Suburbia puts the points up on the board first with four.
First points of the game for Suburbia. Suburbia with a couple of big wins this season. This is their second trip to division playoffs, so no strangers to the fray. Both of these teams with a lot of experience. We'll be talking about that later on. Charlotte Bukowski is ready to go for Suburbia and for the Saddle Tramps of Tucson. Death Proof on the jam line.
And we are off. A little jammer tussle, more of a little nice little push there.
Well, both teams trying to feel each other out, John, in the early going, and no clear advantage in this pack work. Both teams holding their walls fairly tightly, especially Tucson up front. Now Tucson with a little bit of running room. Oh, nice takeout. It's going to be an improper pass. No pass, no penalty. So we have a jammer in the front who is death proof. She is not lead jammer. However, lots of action in the front of the pack and a scoring pass now for death proof. She puts five on the board despite not being lead jammer. Stuck in the back right now for Suburbia is Charlotte Bukowski.
Charlotte Bukowski now trying to make it. Now her, I believe this is her third or fourth attempt to get through. She's been knocked to the outside in each of those attempts as another pass is taken care of by death proof, and that's another five in the sky. So that brings Tucson up to 10 points. We have a multiplayer block penalty right now called on Tucson, who's going to take a seat in the notorious RED penalty box. That's number three, Pinky McLovin, taking the seat.
And the star is finally passed to Veloce Villan. She's able to put it on, but an immediate call off. Three more for Tucson takes them to 13-4.
Adam Wheels is a proud partner of the WFTDA for 6 years running. Big thanks to Adam Wheels. You can find them at adamwheels.com.
And Lauren Forcer ready to go at the Fast Girl Skates jam line. And Mystery Meat ready to go for Tucson. Mystery Meat showed a great ability yesterday to get through the pack unscathed on the initial pass. Let's see what she can do against Suburbia. She is running against a two wall up front. Meanwhile, in the back, Suburbia having a little bit of difficulty springing Lauren Forcer. One skater to beat up front, but the pack is fast today. John Maddening.
Moving back around, trying to spin around, getting caught up behind that two wall up in front. That's Lauren Forcer, who just gets passed by Mystery Meat to become lead jammer for Tucson.
Mystery Meat on a scoring run. Lauren Forcer able to jump the apex. You saw it there. She's not lead jammer. Another jumping the apex for Mystery Meat. Lovely work. 4 points for Tucson.
And that brings Tucson up to 17. Suburbia has not scored since that first jam. They are sitting pretty at four right now.
And on the Fast Girl Skates jam line, Pixie Axe, number 33 in black for Tucson, and number 382, Charlotte Bukowski for Suburbia. If you're just tuning in, Suburbia in red and Tucson in black.
So Tucson's running it. They've had a small core of skaters here that have been here since about 2008, but there's a lot of new faces on this team, so it's going to be interesting to see what they can do this weekend.
Well, Pixie Axe has been the premier jammer for Tucson throughout this divisional playoff, and you see her up front, just a couple of skaters in red to beat. Meanwhile, the troubles continue in the back of the pack. We have a lead jammer. It is Pixie Axe. And still difficulty now for Charlotte Bobowski getting through in the back end.
Trying to make her way through, going around the outside, has two big skaters to get through.
Well, that's Blaxican Bomber along with Death Proof doing the work up front. And Pixie Axe picks up a quick 5 points. Still no light at the end of the tunnel for Charlotte Bobowski.
Blaxican Bomber gets knocked out to the outside, but gets right back in the thick of it.
And now back on a third scoring run, and a power jam will take place. We have a penalty called for cutting the track on Charlotte Bobowski, and Pixie Axe through unscathed. Five more. Tucson in danger of making this a runaway.
Very smart move by Pixie Axe there. You could see she was just about to call it off, and then she made that final check, saw that Charlotte was sitting in the box, and decided to risk it, go for a little bit more. Charlotte's already standing, as that, of course, this year's 30-second penalties have taken effect.
Well,
and she is re-entering the pack as we see.
And still in control is Pixie Axe. Charlotte Bobowski has still not completed an initial pass, so Pixie Axe has plenty of breathing room right now. Now Charlotte Bobowski gets through, John. Pixie Axe just looking for a couple more.
Just under 10 seconds remaining in this jam, but it is going to be called off by Pixie Axe, so no more points scored by Suburbia there. Tucson now up to 37. Suburbia still at 4. Experienced derby skaters getting you the right gear to take you to the next level. That's Derby for All. Located in beautiful St. Paul, Minnesota, or online anytime at derby4, that's the number 4, all.com.
First time jamming for Suburbia Veloce Villain, and she's going to be jamming against Runnin' Heidi for Tucson. Runnin' Heidi facing a tough wall in the back of the pack. Veloce Villain has the wall to deal with up in front. Tucson enjoys the front of the pack, and they seem to really know what they're doing up there, John.
Yeah, they're doing a great job of just controlling the Suburbia jammer. And right now, she's making the break for it, and she finally does. This might be the break, the little chink in the wall that they need.
Veloce Villain picking up lead jam in her first time wearing the star. She's back around quite quickly, engaging the pack on a scoring pass, as we'll see who coming up into turn number 3 now. This is much needed for Suburbia. 5 on the board for Veloce Villain, still in the back of the pack. For Tucson is Runnin' Heidi.
And another 5 in the sky, another 5 big derby points for Veloce Villain of Suburbia, and this is exactly what Suburbia needs right now.
And the star has been passed to Bonita. Bonita, a defensive gem for Tucson yesterday, and she's not able to pick anything up. 2 more on the board for Veloce Villain, and that narrows the gap. Suburbia on 16, Tucson 37.
Yeah, that's kind of a moral victory right there. That's kind of, they just hadn't scored since that first jam. And finally, they were able to get through 4 jams later. And after Tucson's already outscored them about 37-4, and was able to pick up a good 12 points there for a total of 16.
Mystery Meat wearing the star for Tucson. And it's Lauren Forcer. Now she's got Blaxican Bomber to deal with. And Lauren Forcer, one of the smaller players on the track, picks up lead, taking down Blaxican Bomber. And Suburbia on a mini run of their own now, John.
2 in a row for Suburbia. You know, sometimes all it takes is that one quick one. There you go. 5 big roller derby points for Suburbia.
And yes, Lauren Forcer not touched. And Mystery Meat recycled all the way back to the pack. Mystery Meat on her initial pass still. Now Blaxican Bomber gets another opportunity against Lauren Forcer. But Lauren Forcer is very cagey. Lots of agility there. She picks up 5 more. And still on an initial pass, Mystery Meat now has cleared the pack. Lauren Forcer immediately back 4 more. She's going to call that one off, John.
Yep, she calls it off, picks up another additional 2 on that last pass, and just like that, Suburbia is back in it, now only trailing by 9, 37-28, Tucson in the lead. Of course, for those of you watching at home on WFTDA.TV, Tucson in the black and gold, Suburbia in the black and red, or red and black, let's say.
And Tucson will be starting this jam down. They have two in the notorious RED penalty box. Tucson only with one. Tucson sends Death Proof up to the top of the pack, jamming for Suburbia is Veloce Villain. Veloce Villain sees an opening. She grabs it, picks up lead jammer. That's three lead jams in a row for Suburbia.
Yeah, nice move there. I think that was just what they needed, that first lead jam in a while. And it just kind of got them going, got them thinking, all right, we can do this. We're not gonna let these Tucson saddle tramps take us down here. 3 points scored by Suburbia.
Those were three hard points picked up by Veloce Villain. The only issue now for Suburbia is a penalty problem in the early going. Nobody really has a whole lot of penalties so far, do they, John?
Not really. We are sitting, Barry Boom Boom has the most. No, she's Barry Boom Boom and Little Loca over on Suburbia both have two. But everybody else is one or zero. It's fine. They're fine. We're all fine here. How are you?
They're going to be. I'm doing well. Thank you. Here in beautiful Duluth, three on in the penalty box for Suburbia to start this jam. And that makes it quite easy for Pixie Axe to get through. She is your lead jammer and already on a scoring pass for Tucson. Pixie Axe now gets through. We'll see how many she gets. She gets five as... Well, Charlotte Bupowski had just enough time to clear the pack before Pixie Axe called that one off, John.
But, I mean, Charlotte can take that as a total victory because they were down by so many skaters out there, and she was able to get it through when she was having trouble when she had a full complement of blockers earlier on. So the fact that they were able to hold them down to only five, that's a victory for Suburbia, in my opinion.
Still two in the box for Suburbia as we are getting ready to start this next one. It is Runnin' Heidi jamming for Tucson and Lauren Forcer for Suburbia. Tough stuff up front, but Runnin' Heidi is able to get through. Lead jammer for the ladies in black.
And Barry Boom Boom just re-enters the pack, and so that means both teams are back up to full strength right now.
Lauren Forcer bounces off that four wall. Nice work as she gets through on the initial pass. Meanwhile, Runnin' Heidi on a scoring run. She's going to have to call this one off. Let's see what she gets, John. She picks up three.
Three. Nice move there by Tucson, showing that they're still in this. They weren't run down a little bit there in those three jams in a row that Suburbia kind of dominated. But then the last two jams, five and three respectively. Tucson now at 45, Suburbia at 31.
And we have five-on-five roller derby. It is Mystery Meat wearing the star for Tucson and for Suburbia. Once again, Veloce Villain. Veloce Villain doing a good job so far for Suburbia, making things happen, and she finds it again on the outside of turn number one. Veloce Villain lead jam Suburbia.
Nice move again. The packet kind of cleared out in the middle, and both jammers were going for the outside.
And we have a track cut assessed on Mystery Meat, and this puts Veloce Villain in the driver's seat. Lead jam, power jam, Suburbia, nice tiptoe move, spinning around on the outside, around Death Proof. That's five more for Veloce Villain.
Balaxican Bomber and number 89 for Suburbia, Tiantini, both also taking a seat in the notorious RED penalty box.
And a second scoring run now for Veloce Villain. She's got unbelievable balance there on the toe stops. Now she's got Death Proof to get around. She's getting some help now. Oh, Veloce Villain able to hold that inside line. Boy, she's putting on a clinic right now.
Fantastic skate work there.
Yes, that's five more for Suburbia. Suburbia drawing within 4 points of the lead now. Veloce Villain still in control of this one. Mystery Meat released from the notorious RED penalty box, but she's still on an initial pass.
As was Blackskin Bomber and Tiantini back in the thick of it. So both teams, as this jam ends, are going to be up to full strength. Four points scored on that last pass.
And that brings these teams to tied up 45-45 apiece. Veloce Villain getting it done for Suburbia, John.
S1 helmets are rad. Get rad. What? That's right, S1 helmets, proud sponsor of the Division II WFTDA tournaments, S1helmets.com.
And slight pack advantage for Suburbia as we're getting underway now. It's Charlotte Bapowski going against Pixie Axe. Pixie Axe caught up in the back by an invigorated wall. And Charlotte Bapowski picks up lead for the ladies in red. Suburbia on a run.
They are really relying on Charlotte Bapowski, and it is showing up. She is doing a very, very good job. She was having some trouble. There's her scoring pass here. Five big dirty points for Charlotte Bukowski of Suburbia. She was having a little trouble in those second, third, fourth jams, but she got back out and in the thick of it, and she is working out very well for Suburbia.
All of a sudden, she's got her confidence. She got through on that initial pass and the second scoring run totally untouched. This time, she picks up four more, and now she's got a decision to make as Pixie Axe has cleared the pack, and quick call off by Suburbia, who have taken the lead 54-45. John,
I'm kind of curious as how they're skating here right now. They are not with their regular coaches. We have a timeout
called by Suburbia.
They're not with their regular coaches. Their coaches are actually skating in a MRDA tournament this weekend. So they have Betsy Rexy, who's the head coach of the Minnesota Roller Girls All-Stars, and Kishmi Deadly from Chippewa Valley in Wisconsin. A couple skaters and coaches that are very well thought of in the Derby community, and they said, hey, can you help us out? And they said, sure. So it's a very Minnesota and Wisconsin nice.
Well, and tell you what, they have been able to assess the talent and put the right players on the court or on the track at the right time.
Yeah, absolutely.
Sometimes a fresh pair of eyes really does help out in that situation.
Well, and I think a lot of coaches too, if you were having as much trouble as Charlotte was having in those first few jams, would have sat her for a few more jams, sat her out. But Betsy had some confidence in there and said, no, get out there. We know you can do it. We know you can rock it out. And she did.
And as a matter of fact, currently this timeout has become an official review as Suburbia. Well, we'll get the official word in just a second as what the point of contention is.
Tucson is looking for a potential cut. Suburbia, I believe, is looking for a potential cut on the jammer. But we're just waiting for the review still, so we'll figure it out.
Well, that was Pixie Axe in that last jam. We'll have to see. But there again, as you said, John, that shows that the support staff, if you will, for Suburbia, despite the fact that they are not the Suburbia regular coaches, are right in the game.
Yeah.
Calling for that
They're
review.
Watching the entire game. They're not just watching their skaters. They're seeing anything that they can jump on and say, hey, we can capitalize on this.
And if you're just tuning in, we want to welcome you to Duluth. This is the D2 Division Playoffs. First tournament of many for WFTDA TV, and we are happy to be bringing it to you. This is day number two. And you have before you the Tucson Saddle Tramps and the Suburban Brawl from Suburbia Roller Derby. Suburbia in red and Tucson in black. We are getting a word on the official review in just a second.
For all your printing needs, you can hit up printcographics.com. That's right, printcographics.com, another proud sponsor of the Division II WFTDA tournaments. Let's throw it over to Captain Lou, who can give us an update.
So yes, indeed. It was a contention that a track cut had been committed by the Tucson Jammer. The jammer ref believed that the jammer got back in before the cut happened, and no call.
And we are back to the action, and as quickly as we can say official review, Lauren Forcer picks up lead jammer, and Death Proof goes to the penalty backs on a track cut. This is a major run now for Suburbia. Blaxican Bomber stopping the bleeding there, sending Lauren Forcer not only back to the back of the pack, but back to 1953. But Lauren Forcer bounces back, picks up five, John.
5 points, and already halfway around the track, two-thirds of the way around the track, already coming up on the back of the pack and making another pass. Tucson switched it to full defensive mode. holding her back form in a diamond formation, knocking her. Oh, she manages to stay in.
Well, all the great athletes have a low center of gravity, and there you see it for Lauren Forcer. That is five more for the ladies in red. Suburbia, Roller Derby's Suburban Brawl. Lauren Forcer in control. She's going to want to try to pick up a couple more before calling it off. She finds her hips. She does. Let's see if she picks up any more. She picks up one for her trouble, John. That takes Suburbia to 65-45.
Yeah, so an even 20 points. Suburbia is now ahead. This is the highest point differential of the game so far in Suburbia's favor. Tucson led by about 31 points before Suburbia got on their tear. But it's going okay for Suburbia now, eh?
Absolutely. Charlotte Popowski on the Fast Girl Skates jam line. She's going up against Mystery Meat for Tucson. Mystery Meat just has a lot of athleticism. And you see it right there. A hole opens up just for a second. She picks up lead jam on the inside. Meanwhile, Charlotte Popowski is caught in the back. And as this game progresses, you're going to see Bonita for Tucson do a lot of great defensive work. She did there. Charlotte Popowski does get through on an initial pass, but Mystery Meat negotiating the pack up on the front. She's got a three wall to beat. How about that? She does a little bit of a hop, picks up her four, calls it off. Tucson getting back in at 49, Suburbia 65.
Notorious Gear Deodorant by Notorious R.E.D. You can order online at NotoriousRED.com. That's NotoriousRED.com, another proud sponsor of the WFTDA tournament season.
And speaking of Notorious R.E.D., the penalty box is empty. 5-on-5 roller derby with somewhat of an old school start. Getting ready to go for this next jam. It is Running Heidi wearing the star for Tucson and Veloce Villain, who's doing a little bit of jammer blocking right there for Suburbia as the walls get a little bit closer. Now you see Veloce Villain working up front. Nice work in the back now by Suburbia holding off Running Heidi, but Running Heidi finds a little room. Does she pick up lead? No! No! Sneaking through on the inside is Veloce Villain, and in hot pursuit, of course, Running Heidi.
And now it becomes a skate race as they skate around, getting closer to the back of the pack. Veloce Villain trying to hold her back. Not a lot of space separating these two right now. Veloce Villain is just kind of slowing it down.
A little bit of positional blocking in play for Veloce Villain. She wants something to set up as her teammates up front are trying to catch a Tucson skater in the back. They are not able to do it. Veloce Villain wisely calls it off. No score.
So Suburbia leads right now 65 to Tucson's 49 with 11 minutes and 4 seconds remaining in this first period.
And 5-on-5 once again to start off. We've seen these jammers go against each other quite a bit. Pixie Axe in black for Tucson. Lauren Forcer, number 50, in red for Suburbia.
Looks like both. Yep, both penalty boxes are empty right now.
That's right, and Pixie Axe finds
nice
the
move.
Inside line. Clearly lead jammer Lauren Forcer hustling to pick up, get through the initial pass. She does. Pixie Axe immediately back, though. You're going to see her coming into your screen in just a second. There she is, and she is on a scoring run. She's got at least one. She's got to be careful, though, as Lauren Forcer approaching from behind. Pixie Axe, that's fast pack work for Suburbia, holding Pixie Axe to 2.
You know, if you want to chat with us, and really, I mean, who wouldn't? I mean, really, I mean, come on, you. You can hashtag your Twitter post at Talk2, that's the number 2, WFTDA. Also, if you're talking about this weekend's playoffs, you want to hashtag Duluth, that's D-U-L-U-T-H. And also hashtag WFTDA playoffs, WFTDA playoffs.
And back to the action, Death Proof jamming for Tucson. Charlotte Popowski jamming for Suburbia, but Charlotte Popowski is going to have to sit down. She is called on a multiplayer block. This gives Tucson a little bit of breathing room, an opportunity to narrow the gap. Death Proof gets through. She is lead jammer 4-on-4 in the pack, but the jammer penalty assessed to Charlotte Bapowski. Here we go now. Death Proof running into some serious defense on the part of Suburbia and running her all the way back to the back of the pack is Little Loca. She is extending that zone just about as far as it can be extended, John.
Yeah, and that 30 seconds is almost already up on the Charlotte Bupowski's penalty. So it's not going to be a whole lot of scores point. We're able to pass all five.
Well, that's a nice bit work. Bit of work by Death Proof. She picks up five, taking Tucson to 56-65 for Suburbia. Mystery Meat re-enters as a jammer now, and still a power start for Tucson.
Bupowski is still standing in the penalty box, the notorious RED penalty box there. I mean, she probably has 1 or 2 seconds remaining on this penalty, so
Was a smart play by Tucson, calling that off, preserving the start, and Mystery Meat is going to go down to the notorious RED penalty box on a back block. Charlotte Bapowski, meanwhile, called for a cut, so Jammers trade penalties. We're going to have a long time jamming in this one. It'll go the full 2 minutes, John.
Absolutely. She's going to take a seat and then get right back up again. Probably about 15-20 seconds will be served as Mystery Meat returns to the pack and can now get her initial score, her initial pass.
And the four wall up front for Suburbia holding so far. And look at Mystery Meat again. Very athletic, very strong. She powers her way through. She, of course, will not be lead jammer. Charlotte Bapowski standing up, and she will rejoin the fray just behind Mystery Meat. But she is one lap behind. Now in a scoring position is Mystery Meat. She is going up against Angry Penguin. Angry Penguin getting some help now up front. And Mystery Meat just continues to push forward. Oh, how about that for Dinosaur Jr.? She's going to have to sit down, but that might have felt good.
Yeah, absolutely. Sometimes it's like a sacrifice hit in baseball, a sacrifice fly. You got to take it if you need to. If you want your team to move forward, you got to. Whoa, a nice little hop there by Mystery Meat.
Mystery Meat showing it all. As I said yesterday, she was able to get through the pack untouched. That's four more on the board for Tucson. They're within 4 points. Charlotte Bapowski finally on her scoring pass. This jam's going to run, and we still have 20 seconds left in it. Bapowski now trying to engage a fast Tucson pack. In the meantime, in the back, we have Mystery Meat. Both teams starting to try to avoid the jammers as best they can. Mystery Meat does get through. Four more. It is a tie game for Tucson. Tucson then takes the lead. 16. Well,
no, no.
just as quickly, second effort by Charlotte Bapowski picks up four quick points. 69-69.
Wow.
With 6 minutes left.
Very nice move there. We have a timeout that is going to be called here.
And this one is going to be called by Suburbia. Suburbia now has two timeouts that they have spent in this first period that could mean something somewhere down the line, John.
You know, if you cannot make it to Duluth, I mean, it's like a 2.5-hour drive for me, but it's a long distance for a lot of people. You can get that tournament merchandise and pretend that you were here. You can go to WFTDA.com/store and pick up this awesome, awesome tournament merch. The graphic design for this year is just fantastic. I love these last few years how the graphic design has been kind of pulling it all together, pulling all the Big Five and then the seven tournaments together with a consistent graphic design, and it's fantastic.
Well, and check them out, WFTDA store for sure. Talking about pulling them together, we saw there Betsy Rexy and Kishmi Deadly settling down their Suburbia charges there. They nice bit of work there. They don't want to let this game get out of control. I think Suburbia really need to play a disciplined game against this Tucson squad.
Yeah, Suburbia's been up by as many as 20 points, and they've been down by, I believe, about 31 is the biggest and smallest differentials there. But right now it's tied, and it's really kind of cool, these Division II tournaments. You're seeing a lot of teams that have not played each other before. In fact, Suburbia, you know, before last night, had never played anyone else in this tournament. Tucson has never played anyone, has never played Suburbia. In fact, before this weekend, they'd only ever played Sin City and Omaha, coincidentally the teams that were seated on either side of them at number 5 and number 7. So it's really cool to see all these younger teams, a lot of them, or teams that have not been at the top of the game for a while, getting back together and getting in the thick of it and playing each other, and oh, it's fantastic.
Back to the action. Pixie X jamming for Tucson. She's got one skater to beat, and it is Veloce Villain wearing the star for Suburbia. Veloce Villain caught up in the back of the pack. Pixie X picks up lead jammer on a scoring run. Here she comes into your screen on the top, and just as quickly is going to be through that pack. That's a 5-point unscathed scoring pass for Pixie X.
Very nice move there. Still trying to get through. Veloce Villain gets stopped. Complete stop there.
And that will be a back block called against Pixie X. She just lowered the boom on Barry Boom Boom for Suburbia. And Veloce Villain, of course, now is tasked with getting through on the initial pass. It can be a power jam. It will be a 2-minute jam. Finally, the star is passed to Dinosaur Jr. Veloce Villain says, Dinosaur, why don't you do the jamming for a little bit? But she's got a tough three wall up front. It is Pinky McLovin holding her off. A track cut. Oh, that one's going to send Dinosaur Jr. to the notorious RED penalty box. And Pixie X is ready to regain control of this one.
And, you know, unfortunately there for Suburbia, that's going to be about 28 seconds served, as Pixie X was just released just as Veloce Villain was sitting down.
Yeah, that penalty could extend into the next jam, as we have 15 seconds left on the jam clock. Pixie X now, Suburbia with one mission. That's to hold her back almost any way they can. They've got four blockers on the track. Now look at Blaxican Bomber there trying to make some room for Pixie X. Pixie X is called for a cut.
A forearm penalty there on number 23, Barry Boom Boom, and then right after that, a track cut on Pixie X.
Well, the NSOs are earning their time in that in that notorious RED penalty box today. There's no question about that. We have an official timeout called on the track, and there's a lot to sort out in this one. One thing for sure, though, on the scoreboard right now, Tucson with a 10-point lead, 4 minutes left in this one. Suburbia battling the whole way, came back from quite a deficit, got a 20-point lead of their own, and now we have a timeout.
All right, looking at penalties so far, Tucson has been doing pretty well. Not a single player with over two penalties, and there's only two with two. That's Blaxican Bomber and Mystery Meat. There's one, Emasculator, Alabama Whirly, Bonita, Death Proof, Pixie X, and Cosmonauti, all with one penalty. Suburbia, Little Loca has been sitting on four for about 10 minutes now, so she was at least able to slow it down a bit. Dinosaur Jr., Barry Boom Boom, and Charlotte Bukowski, all with three penalties, and Rogue Pirogue with two.
We have an explanation of that last stoppage of play now.
The initiator of the hit was a clockwise block, so it was not a track cut. The initiator went to the penalty box. So both jammers on the track.
Thank you very much, Captain Lou.
Thank you, Captain Lou. Running Heidi out in front, lead jammer for Tucson. She's running into a short wall for Suburbia. And Suburbia, nothing on the board on that one. I'm looking for the points. Oh, nothing. Huh. Nothing for Running Heidi either. That's some nice defensive work by Suburbia.
Yeah, as referee Zedork there, I had to go ahead and check out with the outside pack ref just to make sure that there was no pass, just to confirm that there are no extra points being awarded.
And two players in the notorious RED penalty box as this jam starts for Suburbia. They send Charlotte Bapowski to the line, and it's Mystery Meat again for Tucson. Oh, and she takes advantage of that pack advantage. Yeah, round, picks up lead jammer.
Round the inside. Lead jammer goes to Tucson.
Well, the penalty box empties. It is 4-on-4 in the pack. Charlotte Bukowski does get through. Mystery Meat on a scoring run now. And a nice nudge to the outside by Brawl Stanley will stop that jam. Only one put on the board by Mystery Meat in that last jam.
And it's another victory for Bupowski, who just kept on going. And when she went out, pretty much forced her to call that jam.
Death Proof wearing the star for Tucson. Now we're down to 2 minutes, 15 seconds left in this first period. And for Suburbia, Veloce Villain, we've got short pack for Suburbia. Suburbia with one in the penalty box. And we have a track cut on Death Proof. And this is a nice little bonus for Veloce Villain. But Veloce Villain having to negotiate this Tucson defense, and that's not an easy task.
No. Veloce Villain went down in turn one there, and just a very athletic, almost doing the worm to get up here. And she's back in the thick of it, back and trying to get past that last blocker. Does and is lead jammer for Suburbia.
That was Cosmonauti, and she was doing a good job of running the clock on that penalty. As we see now, Death Proof sprung from the notorious RED penalty box on a scoring pass, however, is Veloce Villain. And Veloce Villain is signaling to the referee that she wants a call. But in the meantime, she's going to make a hand signal that she can make, which is finding her hips to stop the jam. She picks up 5 points for Suburbia.
So after the 22nd jam, that is Tucson leads 81 to Suburbia's 74. Little Loca now up to 5 trips to the notorious RED penalty box. Barry Boom Boom with 4. So those are the ones are going to have to watch themselves in the second half there. 45 seconds remaining in this half, so time for one more jam.
And that'll bring Pixie Axe to the forefront. Oh, nice work there up in the front. That'll send Pixie Axe all the way to the back. Lauren Forcer wearing the star for Suburbia, but Pixie Axe finds the hole on the inside of turn number 2. Lead jammer, 24 seconds left on the period clock. Lauren Forcer has a mission now. She has to get through. The last thing that Suburbia wants right now is to go into the halftime giving up a big jam. Lauren Forcer able to do it. Pixie Axe has one to beat up front, and that is Little Loca. Again, Pixie Axe gets around Little Loca, calls off the jam, and that is 4 more Tucson points, 89 for Tucson, 74 for Suburbia. Well, 85. The scoreboard was very quick adding those last 4 points.
Absolutely. So it's only an 11-point game right now. It's been as many as 31 points lead by Tucson and as many as 20 points led by Suburbia. So it's very tight here, and We're seeing some fun derby out here in the D2 tournament.
Well, absolutely, and we are looking forward to bringing you the second period of this one in just about 14 minutes. And don't forget, as you're making your plans for your derby watching today, next up we've got St. Chuck's versus Big Easy, and that's going to be a fun bout as well. We will bring you the second half of this game in just about 14 minutes. Thanks for watching WFTDA-TV.
They told us to just sell skates online. You won't have any overhead. Put some skulls in your advertising, you'll make a mint. That was never our plan. Our plan was to make a store where all day we are fitting skaters, fixing skates, teaching customers, and putting the best gear on their bodies. Before we put 3 W's in front of our name, we made sure we had hundreds of happy customers come through our doors. We're not just derby owned, we're derby dedicated. Fast Girl Skates.
We'll be right back. Bring it in. Keep coming. Ooh. Time for an upgrade. Radar Presto.
Say, these are nice.
Stunning.
On you go.
Is Brenda Gold, and I've been at Rydell for 36 years almost. Everything is done by hand, basically. Just a one pair actually going through at a time then. And some of them are multiple colors where it'll have five, six colors. Metallics, the different colored full grains, you name it. Some of them are pretty wild. To me, the skaters are really important because that's what keeps us going here. It's the consumer or the skater that decides, okay, is it good enough for me or not? We want them to be happy, that's for sure.
Back to Duluth, Minnesota for the second period between the Suburban Brawl from Suburbia Roller Derby and the Saddle Tramps of Tucson Roller Derby. Tucson with a lead right now, 85-74. John Maddening, why don't you tell us a little bit about the statistical aspect of this game?
Well, Suburbia jumped out to an early lead, 4-0. But then Tucson came right back and they led by up to 31. Suburbia came back, charged back and led a pretty tough scoring pass. They led by as many as 20. Now Tucson leads at the half by 11. Lead scorers for Tucson: Pixie Axe with 14, Mystery Meat with 23, and Death Proof with 18. On Suburbia side, Volace Vixen with 34, Lauren Forcer with 27, and Charlotte Bupowski with 13. But Charlotte has been really beaten up out there, but doing a lot of beating herself. She was having a tough time in those first few jams, but then really came back and is just doing a heck of a job out there.
You know, and that's well-distributed scoring among the jammers so far, so no clear advantage for any of the jammers. I do want to correct the misstatement that I made right at the end of the first period. For those of you who are making your plans to view WFTDA TV coverage of the Duluth D2 tournament, our next bout will be St. Chuck's versus Sin City. I think I got caught up in the excitement and said it was going to be versus Big Easy. That's wrong. Your brackets are correct. Gretchen the Axe is an idiot. It's going to be St. Chuck's versus Sin City. And we have a very little time left before this one is going to get underway. Again, these two teams now playing for pride, playing for a potential of a fifth place seeding at the end, or a fifth place ranking at the end of this tournament, but they're also playing for next year's rankings, given the fact that if they win, they get more games, John.
Yeah, they get more games. The points that they score are worth more in these tournaments, in the playoffs here. The winner of this game is going to take on Brandywine tonight at 8 p.m. Central. And the loser will go tomorrow morning at 10 a.m., the coveted 10 a.m. slot, against Omaha. So the winner can get as high as fifth place. The loser of this game can get as high as ninth place.
And we've got seconds before the bout gets underway once again. It's 5-on-5 roller derby. Charlotte Bapowski on the jam line for Suburbia, and Pixie Axe, the captain of the Saddle Tramps, ready to go for Tucson. If you just joined us, Tucson in the black, Suburbia in the red. And we have a more current type of start to this jam on the Fast Girl Skate jam line. Charlotte Bapowski gets a little bit of an advantage out front right now, but she's got Blackskin Bomber to get around. She does. She's lead jammer. Suburbia taking lead jam to start this second period.
Yeah, and this is going to be one of those times that she's going to want to get that just to kind of break the ice, as it will. She wants to get through there. She had, like I said earlier, she was having some tough times earlier on in that first half. She picks up 3 points here. When she's on, she's totally on, and that's fantastic. But she can get tripped up a little bit, and you need these moral victories early on in the half, early on in a period, early on in a game, to figure out, to get your feet underneath you and work it out.
And Tucson with some serious defenders, and that can give a slightly built jammer like Charlotte Bapowski some fits. We're getting ready to start the second jam of the period. It is Death Proof for Tucson going up against Lauren Forcer for Suburbia. No definite leader at this point, as both teams playing some pretty solid pack work. Lauren Forcer looks to the middle. She can't make it. She's ridden out by Picky McLovin, and that gives Death Proof all she needs. She picks up lead jammer for Tucson, and Death Proof is immediately back in the pack.
As the pass makes through, grabs it, calls it off, picks up 4 points. And you really saw when the pack was together there, what the size advantage that Tucson had there. Tucson, every single one of their blockers was bigger than every single one of the Suburbia blockers. Both jammers about the same size and able to, you know, cut through, very speedy, very very agile. But just the power that Tucson had in those larger blockers was really working to their advantage.
89-77, Tucson holding the cards right now. They send Mystery Meat to the line versus Veloce Villain. It is 5-on-5 roller derby, and Veloce Villain has one to beat up front. She got a quick start. Mystery Meat caught in the back, and we have a lead jammer. It is Veloce Villain for Suburbia. Mystery Meat was able to power her way through as well. A little bit of a scattered pack as Veloce Villain hitting the scoring zone. She calls it off. She slides around Bonita. She picks up one for her troubles. Suburbia on 78, Tucson on 89.
The Blue Streak by Rydell. Raw power just adds skater. Rydell Skates from beautiful Red Wing, Minnesota. RydellSkates.com, a proud sponsor of the WFTDA playoff season.
And still 5-on-5 roller derby, quite clean to start off this second period. Charlotte Bapowski wearing the star for Suburbia against Pixie Axe. It's a replay of the first jam of the second period. Pixie Axe goes down, but she quickly back up. Again, no clear advantage for either of these jammers. The coaching staff must have had a couple of talks with their pack players at halftime. Pixie Axe now, though, able to round her way through. She picks up lead jammer. Bonita is going to have to sit down for Tucson, but in charge, the ladies in black.
Yeah, Pixie Axe there, when she was going through that pack, she was kind of going, she was stuck in the inside and then coming around, a nice little sine wave almost, in, out, until she finally did make it through. She picks up 2 points on that pass, 0 for Suburbia, kind of chipping away, getting a little closer to that century mark. Tucson at 91, Suburbia at 78.
And it's a pack advantage for Suburbia. They're going to send Lauren Forcer to the Fast Girl Skates jam line. Death Proof on that line for Tucson. And we have a spread pack start. Of course, Tucson on the pivot line with the short pack. And Suburbia going to try to wall up on Death Proof immediately. It's slow going as Lauren Forcer looking for a break, and she does not find a break. She finds Cosmonauti instead.
Whoa! There she goes. A nice, nice move around the outside there by Death Proof. As the Suburbia blockers were trying to help out their jammers a little bit, she ended up going around the outside and picking up lead jammer status for Tucson. Followed caught on her skates, though.
Well, we're going to see now whether Laura Enforcer was able to pick anything up.
0-0, null, goose egg for both teams there.
Well, Laura Enforcer might have wanted a couple on that one, John. It is 91-78 in favor of Tucson. Mystery Meat is ready to jam against Veloce Villain, and Tucson enjoying a 4-3 pack advantage right now to start this one off as Tiantini is sitting in the notorious RED penalty box. We are underway. Mystery Meat finds the outside line, but she is knocked off of it quickly by Barry Boom Boom, and she's going to have to be recycled up in the front of the pack. Veloce Villain fighting hard against Blackskin Bomber, and Mystery Meat powering through. Suburbia spending their energy attempting to get Veloce Villain through, and that gave Mystery Meat all she needed.
Yeah, Veloce Villain trying to narrow that gap there as Mystery Meat comes up on the back of this very light pack. Mystery Meat making her move now to Suburbia line. Oh, gets bashed around there.
Nice
calls
work
it off
by
3 points.
Pirogue there for Suburbia, stopping that jam. It's 94 now in favor of Tucson, 78 for Suburbia. Suburbia needing a big jam.
Absolutely. Roller bones and bones bearings make for a winning combination. You can extend your skating career and wear TSG's protective gear. Everything's from rollerbones.com, another proud sponsor of the WFTDA.
Charlotte Boposky on the line for Suburbia, and it's Pixie Axe for Tucson. Suburbia with the pack advantage this time. Pixie Axe running over Angry Penguin, but no call. It is lead jammer Charlotte Bapowski. Pixie Axe still caught in the back of the pack. This is the break Suburbia was looking for. Pixie Axe continues to have difficulty on this particular initial pass as the defense for Suburbia tightening up. Now on a scoring run is Charlotte Bapowski, and up in the front you see a little tangling between Angry Penguin and Pixie Axe. Pixie Axe finally able to get through. Charlotte Bapowski's going to have to call this one off. She does pick up 3 points, John Manning. That'll take Suburbia to 81, Tucson on 94.
So that would be 13 points separating these two teams. I am loving this game. Back and forth and back and forth. Very, very tight game. Lots of fun. Lots of big hits. Lots of speed out there. It's been a heck of a one to watch here.
And as we are getting ready to get underway, Death Proof wearing the star at the Fast Girl Jam line for Tucson. It's Lauren Forcer for Suburbia, and Death Proof is hit proof on that one. She was unscathed getting through the pack, lead jammer for Tucson.
And she comes up on the back of the pack to make her scoring pass. Takes a bit of a tumble, but gets right back up and in the thick of it again.
And still...
We have a call. She was called off with a back block penalty.
Well, that is a break for Suburbia. Lauren Forcer still having a difficult time with this four wall up front. It is Alabama Worley along with Blackskin Bomber. Blackskin Bomber tries to take her out with a hip check. Nice balance by Lauren Forcer, able to shrug off that blow.
Yeah, there's that fancy footwork we've been seeing from Lauren Forcer all game long. She's able to tip-tap through her way on her toe stops sometimes, just kind of moving her way through that pack when she needs to.
Yeah.
She gets nearly knocked out a lot of times, but she manages to always just kind of grab that inside little bit of the line there and stay inbounds.
There you see her again, getting around Blaxican Bomber on her right leg only. That's a 5-point scoring pass. Suburbia is up to 81 now. Tucson with 94. Both jammers back on the track, and a lot of players on the track. Lauren Forcer is called for a high block. No, it's Blackskin Bomber called for a high block. Lauren Forcer was looking up at the referees going, oh my goodness, what just happened? And Blackskin Bomber's going to have to sit down to the notorious RED penalty box. 5 more on the board for Lauren Forcer. It's 91 now for Suburbia, 94 for Tucson.
3-point game. This might change it right here as Lauren Forcer gets through one more time, and this will be a lead change. 5 more points on the board for Suburbia. Suburbia takes the lead 96-94.
And Death Proof gets four of her own for Tucson. Tucson on 98 now. And Death Proof untouched for a quick five-point pass at the end of that jam. Four more for Lauren Forser.
Wow.
You know, we're going to have a couple of moments where you might be able to go get yourself a snack, but stay close to your computer or your television, ladies and gentlemen, because this one is going back and forth.
Yeah, three-point game. Tucson leads 103 to Suburbia's 100. There are 20 minutes and 12 seconds remaining in this game. So looking over at the penalties, Suburbia still getting a little scary here for a couple of them. Barry Boom Boom and Little Loca, both at five penalties. Dinosaur Jr. and Aldenamite.
Well, something you don't normally see at this level of play. The game got underway while the referees were still taking charge of what's going on in the notorious RED penalty box. So we have a call off. I think we have a phantom jam may have just occurred, John Madden.
All right, Radar Presto is a proud sponsor of the WFTDA broadcast. Big thanks to Radar Presto and RadarWheels.com.
It's a three-point game as the officials continue to take care of business in the infield. Now on the jam line, the Fast Girl Skate jam line, two of the premier jammers for both of these teams. We've got Veloce Villain versus Mystery Meat. How is their scoring
Mystery Meat so far? Yeah, Mystery Meat so far has 26 points on the board. Going up against Veloce Villain with 35, so pretty close. Veloce Villain with nine more points than Mystery Meat, but it's a team effort here. Both teams have pretty even scoring wise. Their scoring is pretty even amongst their three jammer rotation here. Pixie Axe with 43, Mystery Meat with 26, and Death Proof with 31 over on the Tucson side. Run and Heidi was in there one time with 3 points over on the Suburbia side. Lauren Forrest with 46, Veloce Villain with 35, and Charlotte Bupowski with 19.
Well, that tells you a lot about the defense for both of these teams, is that they are able to contain the jammers to some extent. Distributed scoring is really quite a testament to the pack play of both of the teams.
And look at these players right now on the screen here. You have Tucson. They seem pretty happy. They're only ahead by three, but they look like they're in control. They look like they're relaxed. Suburbia, not so much. Suburbia is kind of rushing around here. They have a little looks of determination on their faces. I don't think they're as certain of their position at the end of this game as Tucson seems to be right now.
Well, Suburbia coming in at a number 9 seed, of course, and we have official timeout still underway, and it's turning into an official review on the part of Suburbia. They are spending their official review fairly early at 19:59 in this second period. They already took two timeouts in the first period, John. So they've obviously got a point they want to make. We'll find out more in just a second.
Yeah, Betsy Rex out there with Little Loca of Suburbia, bringing up their position, making sure that it's not Lincoln Douglas debate or anything, but we'll figure it out.
Well, Suburbia with currently two skaters in the notorious RED penalty box. Now,
let's toss it over to Captain Lou, who will let us know what they're talking about right now.
So Suburbia is challenging that the Tucson jammer came out of the penalty box and re-entered in the engagement zone in front of a Suburbia blocker, which would be an illegal procedure. So we will see what the result is after the referees have conferred.
Yeah, that can happen even in high-level play, even in like heavy, heavy players. Just last week in Minnesota versus Rat City, Slam to Phage came out and did nearly the exact same thing, and it cost her another trip to the box, and a very, very close game there. But this time, there's lining up, and we're going to see what happens. As soon as Captain Lou gets that info back, we will bring it to you.
You can see that it's 3-on-2 in the pack in favor of Tucson as this one gets underway. Again, it's Veloce Villain jamming for in their crouch there behind Mystery Meat for Tucson, and we are almost ready to get back to live derby. Captain Lou's getting the official word here, and he will have more information for us in just a second.
Yes, so the question was whether the Tucson jammer had come in at the front of the engagement zone, but she had entered more than 20 feet in front of the pack. So no illegal procedure, no penalty, and Suburbia loses their official review.
Mystery Meat and Veloce Villain both have made their way through on their initial pass. Mystery Meat calls it off, becoming having a new jammer. 4 points scored for Tucson. That'll bring them up to 107. Suburbia still at 100, even 100.
Quick four-point hit and quit, and that's what Tucson likes to do. The stop. We'll see how the stoppage of play for that long affects both of these teams, because sometimes you get momentum, and you really don't want the game to stop for that long, John.
I mean, it's physical momentum, getting those toxins working through your body, but it's also that mental momentum. If you're going through, if you're scoring a lot of points, if time is on your side, then to stop it, and it can wreck you inside.
Pixie Axe up front for Tucson. She is working on Angry Penguin along with Dinosaur Jr., I believe. And in the back of the pack, having her own trouble, is Charlotte Bupowski. We've gone 24 seconds, almost 25 seconds. We have no lead jammer so far in this one. Defense really tightening up, John.
Yeah, very tight down to the inside. Trying to make a move is Charlotte Bupowski, who gets knocked down and holding the side of her head.
And that's another high block called on Blaxican Bomber. And Blaxican Bomber, Tucson does not want to lose her. And Pixie Axe does evade a shot by Rogue Pirogue. She is lead jammer after 55 seconds of play for Tucson. And finally escaping Charlotte Bupowski for Suburbia. Pixie Axe is going to pick up 4 points and call this one off. Tucson on a slight run of their own, taking it up to 111-100 for Suburbia.
Now, you saw Charlotte there. She was holding her head as she went down. Medical is going to be looking at her right now. But really, when she finally got going again, you saw that look of anger and determination, exactly what she needed to just, you know, anger power.
That's right. It's a 4-2 pack in favor of Suburbia. We have Lauren Forcer on the line for the ladies in red. Death Proof jamming for Tucson. Oh my goodness. That is a crushing blow dealt out by Dirty Duchess. She's going to run Lauren Forcer all the way back. Meanwhile, Death Proof up front working against the Suburbia 3-wall. Back up front and wasting no time to get there is Lauren Forcer. Death Proof still having troubles of her own.
Oh,
nice
boy.
Takeout by Barry Boom Boom. Her momentum took her out of bounds, so she wasn't able to recycle Death Proof. But on a scoring pass right now, Lauren Forcer spins around. And what will she get out of this one? The jam rep
says
4 points.
Wow.
Boy, that is a lovely play by Lauren Forcer for Suburbia.
Yeah, both of those jammers just getting knocked around, knocked down, knocked out of bounds. But that time, Lauren Forcer was able to take it, was able to capitalize on her final position there and grab some points, bring them within seven now. Tucson with 111, Suburbia with 104. We have 16 minutes, 15 seconds remaining in this game.
4-2 pack advantage for Suburbia. Veloce Villain up front, Mystery Meat wearing the star for Tucson. She's taken down by Dinosaur Jr. Veloce Villain out in front. She is lead jammer as Brawl Stanley recycling Mystery Meat all the way back to the back of the pack. Mystery Meat trying some defense of her own. We've got a 5-point pass by Veloce Villain, pulling these teams perilously close to another tie. A 111-109. Mystery Meat finally through the pack. And Blackskin Bombers all that's standing between a lead change for Suburbia as Veloce Villain spinning around Blaxican Bomber, picking up 4 more points, John.
Yeah, Mystery Meat really kind of lost her footing, lost her forward momentum there when she tried to take out the opposing jammer. And it really showed. Suburbia was able to capitalize on that. 113-111. It's a two-point game right now. Adam is a proud sponsor of the WFTDA for 6 years running. You can check them out at adamwheels.com.
Three-on-three pack. It is Pixie Axe wearing the star for the ladies in black, the Tucson Saddle Tramps. It is Lauren Forcer for Suburbia. And Lauren Forcer is up in the front. Does she pick up lead jammer? She does not. There was an improper pass involved. Pixie Axe does get the call. Lead jam for Tucson. And she's got a decision to make. She makes it. She calls it off. Lauren Forcer almost getting up to Bonita, and that would have been points for Suburbia that Tucson does not want to give up.
Yeah, it was more of a decision that her bench was making for her. They all jumped up and were, no, call it off, call it off. Fast Girl Skates, 7 years dedicated to making a faster you. Fast Girl Skates in beautiful Seattle, Washington. You can find them online at fastgirlskates.com.
Speaking of Fast Girl Skates, on the Fast Girl Skates start line, we have Dinosaur Jr. in her first jam of the bout for Suburbia. She picks up lead jam. In the back is Death Proof, still not through on an initial pass. You're going to see right there she is, Dinosaur Jr. on a scoring run. She's trying to get around Black Skin Bomber. Black Skin Bomber has her in her sights. Dinosaur Jr. goes down and calls it off from her back. What is the count? It is four for Suburbia. And
a low block penalty for Black Skin Bomber. That she has gotten three in the past couple minutes here. That'll be her fifth trip to the box.
And Downtown Dave for Tucson says, we want a timeout. This one called before things get any farther out of hand. Suburbia on top, 117-111. Plenty of time, though. 13 minutes, 34 seconds left in this second period, John.
We had some track maintenance folks working out there, taking advantage of the timeout to make sure the track is taped down.
Yeah,
always happy to see. Big thanks to all the volunteers that are working here this weekend. Not only on the track, but behind the scenes here. There's a lot of volunteers, a lot of people giving up their time to come to this tournament. That they're not going to see a lot of games just because they want to make it run. So big thanks to everyone who's given up their time this weekend. Make sure that if you want to talk to us, and who wouldn't really, you want to talk to WFTDA is the official hashtag, talk to the number two, WFTDA. Also, hashtag Duluth and hashtag WFTDA playoffs. Thanks for watching WFTDA TV. Remember, if you are listening to the audio stream, you can get the video, the high-quality video, for only $7 for the weekend. That'll be the same for next week up in Canada, when you'll have $7 as well for an entire weekend of roller derby action.
And it is 2-on-2 in the pack. We've got Mystery Meat and Veloce Villain. They've seen a lot of each other jamming so far. Mystery Meat for Tucson. She's ridden out by Lauren Forcer. Lead jammer picked up by Veloce Villain. And Mystery Meat again taken all the way back, this time by Little Loca. And Mystery Meat picks up five. Suburbia on a run.
The pack has not even made it past the pivot line, and she's already gone. This will be her third pass through. Second scoring pass. Boom. Five more points for Suburbia, knocking them up to 127.
Veloce Villain.
And still, this pack is still sticking there.
Getting it done and making matters worse for Tucson. We have a track cut called on Mystery Meat. That makes it a power jam for the ladies in red. Suburbia taking a 132-111 lead right now into the pack with power to spare. Five more for Veloce Villain. And right now, Tucson is looking to each other saying, we have to shore up this wall. Here's Veloce Villain once again. She's working against she's working against Dirty Duchess up front along with Cosmonauti, but she's able to get through all of them, and that is five more.
Wow.
Big jam, John Maddening.
This is Suburbia's largest lead so far in this game, 142-111. That's 31 points, and she's just adding to them as we speak.
Mystery Meat is out of the notorious RED penalty box right now, but she's still on an initial pass. Angry Penguin takes her back, and right now, Veloce Villain just kind of surveying the scene. Does she want a little more action with Dirty Duchess? She gets around Dirty Duchess and picks up five more. Veloce Villain just bouncing off of those big hits, John.
Goodness gracious, sinks alive. This is a huge, huge jam, a huge, huge move for Suburbia. With only 11 and a half minutes left, they take a 147 to 111 lead. 36 points separate these two teams.
And an illegal procedure call is being assessed on the jammer, Mystery Meat. She is going to have to sit down. Bad to worse for Tucson right now. There are four. We have an official timeout called on the track. Plenty of action to sort out. John Maddening.
Yeah. What can you say about this game? I mean, this has been back and forth and back and forth. It's been super close, and it's been nice large distances between these two teams. But oh, my goodness gracious. Suburbia just on a tear in these last couple jams here. That last big, big jam brought them out to their biggest lead of the game, actually the biggest lead of the game. The highest differential before now had been Tucson leading by 31 points, and that was after about, I think, jam 5. This is now after jam 39. Suburbia leads by 36 points.
Now, penalties, of course, a factor in any game, but it seems like the penalty pendulum, if you will, has swung against Tucson right now. They have two sitting in the notorious RED penalty box, one of whom is Mystery Meat. This could be her seventh trip, is that correct? As she, no, she's going to the end of the bench. No, she is leaving the field of competition. That is seven trips, am I correct, John?
No, that was only four, so we're unsure of why she's taking off there.
Well,
but she's at four, Pinky McLovin is at four, Bone Ida and Dirty Duchess also all at four. Over on the Suburbia side, Barry Boom Boom has got to be very, very careful as she has six trips to the box. Little Loca with five. And I believe she got all five of those before the first half was over. So she's been doing very well in this second half. And we're going to toss it over to Captain. We're not going to toss it over to Captain Lou. I lied to you, ladies and gentlemen.
Well,
what I do.
Our crack producer staff is going to get a clarification on that. The only thing I can expect is that it would have been an expulsion against Mystery Meat.
So, yes, 717 Mystery Meat expelled from the game for an egregious late hit. So
okay.
An egregious illegal procedure. She is done for this game.
And really, that I don't want to call it before it's over, but Mystery Meat was a huge, huge asset to Tucson, scoring 30 of their points in 12 jams.
Well, that had to be a frustrating jam, that last one, and the frustration continues for Tucson. Five more on the board. Lauren Forcer wearing the star for the ladies in red. Suburban Brawl still on an initial pass is death proof. She's just been sent out onto the track from the notorious RED penalty box. She put the star on in place of Mystery Meat. And death proof now ridden out by Brawl Stanley, but Brawl Stanley not able to contain herself. Five more on the board for Lauren Forcer. I was unclear whether she had picked up a jam or a lap point on that. She did. It's 157 Suburbia, 111 Tucson.
Lauren Forcer now has 60 points over her 14 jams today. Veloce Villain, who will be wearing the jammer star next for Suburbia, has 74 points over her 14 appearances. And over on Tucson's side, Runnin' Heidi, it's making only her sixth appearance now. She has 3 points, and she'll try to add to that Tucson total. Still a lot of time left in the game, nearly 10 minutes to go.
Veloce Villain wearing the star for Suburbia and shows that balance once again, able to avoid a shot from Blaxican Bomber. She is lead jammer, and it's a pack advantage for Suburbia. One more blocker getting ready to rejoin the action in the notorious RED penalty box. Here is a scoring pass by Veloce Villain. Look at that acceleration getting around Pinky McLovin. That's five more Suburbia points, and Boy, Ron and Heidi getting all she can from a small but powerful pack. That's Angry Penguin along with Aldanamite for Suburbia holding off.
Yeah, Aldanamite doing a great job here. A definite size disadvantage, but doing a great job of using her momentum to just push out the opposing jammer, doing a great job at defense there.
Ron and Heidi still on an initial pass. Veloce Villain taken to the outside of turn number one, but she calls that one off. She picks up two more, and Suburbia just making a haymaker over the last 5 minutes. Takes the score up to 171. Tucson stuck on 111.
I really hope you folks at home saw that little somersault that she used to get back up and into it again. That was a nice little move there. Big smiles on the faces now of Suburbia. Very little different than just about 10 minutes ago when Tucson kind of thought they had this, I think.
Lauren Forcer, lead jam once again. Suburbia, Pixie X getting through herself for Tucson. But in charge of this jam so far, Lauren Forcer. We haven't seen many mistakes by either of these teams right now. Lauren Forcer ridden hard to the middle. Coming in with a bullet is Pixie X. Pixie X picks up two. Suburbia picks up two, and that one is a wash.
Yeah, the score differential does not change. Suburbia still in the lead by 173. Over Tucson's 113. That's a 60-point lead. 7 minutes, 10 seconds remaining in this game.
Well, first jam of the day for TNTini for Suburbia. She is getting ready against Death Proof now. It's a slight pack advantage for Tucson.
Brawl Stanley and number 66, Lil Loca, doing a great job of holding
and
out.
And direction of gameplay called
very
against
nice move.
Death Proof. And it's not really a power jam until the jammer for the opposing team is able to get through. She does. She is lead jammer. It is now officially a power jam, John Maddening. And in control is TNTini.
Coming through on her scoring pass now, runs right into Tucson blockers.
Oh, that was Bonita getting a little bit of her own medicine. Bonita's been flattening skaters all weekend long here in Duluth. Look at TNTini now working against Cosmonauti. Cosmonauti giving no quarter. She's got help from Blaxican Bomber up there. And TNTini is fighting for her life up in that front wall. And finally, it looks like she's got a purchase against Blaxican Bomber. She does. She picks up five, an out-of-play call against Blaxican Bomber adds to the woes of Tucson.
Dinosaur Jr., Angry Penguin, Little Loca, amazing defense here at the end of this game. They should be tired. They should be falling over themselves, but they are on it. They are holding back these opposing jammers. A fantastic job here of defense by Suburbia at the end of the game. Really pulling it together finally.
And finally through on an initial pass is Death Proof. We have the star passed now to Dinosaur Jr. as TNTini had enough. Of course, what that does is prevents Suburbia from being able to call off the jam, but that is a deal they are willing to make right now, John.
3 points on that last pass scored by Suburbia. Coming up on the back of the pack.
Suburbia speeding up this pack. They may not have size in this jam, but they do have speed. And that's it. The jam is expiring. It's three more for Dinosaur Jr. and the ladies from New York.
Wowzers. Suburbia now at 184. Tucson at 113. 71-point differential right now.
Timeout called on the track by Downtown Dave, getting the saddle tramps together there, going through some scenarios for the last 4 minutes and 59 seconds of this one. But John Maddening, Suburbia, there's just not enough you can say about the positive slant they put on this game in the last 20 minutes.
Yeah, they really took this from what looked like it was going to be a blowout in those first four jams on the side of Tucson and kept it close. Kept it closer, took a small lead, and then Tucson took a small lead, and eventually, in these last 10, 15 minutes, Suburbia has just poured on the gas and just torn it up. Lead by 71 points. with 4 minutes, 49 seconds remaining in this game. And it looks like Suburbia is going to be going forward. Don't want to call it before it's over, but if they keep it going for these last 4.5 minutes, 5 minutes, they're going to be on their way to game number 12 tonight at 8 p.m. against Brandywine.
And it's a 3-on-3 pack. We've got Veloce Villain for Suburbia going against Pixie Axe. And the Jammers are duking it out a little bit, trying to find a hole in the pack. Defense is tough, no clear advantage. Pixie Axe and Veloce Villain still looking for a hole. Pixie Axe tries the outside. Veloce Villain tries the inside. Nothing doing there, as that is being held up by Pinky McLovin. And finally, putting on the gas is Pixie Axe. She picks up lead jammer, a much-needed lead jam for Tucson, and a track cut is called right now. That's going to send Veloce Villain to the penalty box. Oh, it's a back, is a forearm called on Veloce Villain, a track cut, immediate
in and out.
Canceling penalties assessed. It's going to be a two-minute jam. And at this point, unless something were to go drastically wrong for Suburbia, two-minute jam is not the worst thing that could happen.
No, not at all. It's like you're playing Monopoly and you just hit the just visiting part of the jail.
And now Suburbia up front, you see them taking that pack in a very fast pace. They want to run away from Pixie Axe as much as possible. Veloce Villain in a scoring run as well. We've got 42 seconds left in this jam, so plenty of time for action. Pixie Axe up front. She's working against Barry Boom Boom. They're going to have to let her go. That is five on the board for Tucson. Tucson needing that. Let's see in the back, though. Veloce Villain getting taken down. Oh, by Pinky McLovin. No call.
No, she was calling. Veloce Villain was calling for a back block, but the refs saw it differently. Pixie Axe through for another 5 points pass there. She is now at 59 points for this game. Tucson at 123.
And Veloce Villain hanging back for the time being, trying to get a shot on Pixie Axe. Pixie Axe up front working against Barry Boom Boom. Jam times out. Two more on the board for Tucson. But with 2 minutes and 48 seconds left, Tucson needs more than two.
Yeah, Tucson is not, they're trying to make this not a runaway in the last minutes of this game. But right now, Suburbia leads 184 to 125. That is 59 points. And, I mean, it can happen. It can happen. A couple of record-setting jams, and we can rock this out. But right now, Suburbia has got to be feeling pretty good about themselves in this second half.
Five-on-five roller derby. It is Lauren Forcer, who has been in top shape all game long, picking up lead jam. 2 minutes left. Pixie Axe wearing the star for Tucson, so with some nice skate work of her own, but she's still not through on an initial pass. Dinosaur Jr. is going to have to recycle her, and now on a scoring run, Lauren Forcer. Let's see what she picks up. She picks up four. No jammer lap point on that one, as Pixie Axe does make it through the pack.
That's running Heidi actually skating right now for Tucson as she comes around to the back of the Suburbia pack. Gets caught up. Suburbia doing a great job of defense up at the front of the pack and retreating just a bit.
And that was Al Dynamite again, showing her blocking chops despite her smaller stature. And running Heidi working up front. Only so much room that she's going to find against Tiantini and Angry Penguin. Another scoring run by Lauren Forcer. And Lauren Forcer splits the uprights. That's four more, John.
Four more for both teams. So that's going to be Suburbia at 197, Tucson at 129. Still going. We still have 35 seconds left in this jam.
And
both jammers making their moves right now, but it's early run through. 5 points for number 50, Lauren Forcer of Suburbia. So that brings her up to a total of 80 for the game. And that brings Suburbia past the double century mark.
And Suburbia coming back They were down by 11 points at halftime, but boy, whatever the guest coaches told them at halftime was extremely good advice. We are running down to the final seconds of this one. Lauren Forcer lets the jam timeout. She picks up an additional 4 points. We have a quick timeout called by Downtown Dave in Tucson, and boy, oh boy, how about it? If you're a Suburbia fan, you've got to be loving this. And actually, if you're a northeastern United States Derby fan, you got to be loving the fact that Suburbia is now going to be taking on a team that they know something about at 8 o'clock today. They're going to be taking on Brandywine, teams who hail from about 100 miles away from each other, despite the geographic diversity that we have here in the D2 division playoffs in Duluth. Two teams that just in their own backyard are going to end up playing against each other at 8 o'clock tonight. And this could be the final jam. We've got 21 seconds on the period clock. It is Pixie Axe for Tucson, and the could-be MVP jammer for Suburbia, Veloce Villain.
Yeah, I don't think that anyone would doubt that. Veloce Villain with 88 points over 16 jams, although Lauren Forcer very close to her with 84 points out of 16 jams as well. Pixie Axe with 61 points out of 16 jams.
And we are underway. It's 5-on-5 Derby. Pixie Axe up front gets the early advantage, but quickly up front to try to give her some difficulty. Lead jam.
Lead jammer status goes to number 33, Pixie Axe. So that'll be the final jam of the game. And the seventh penalty goes to Barry Boom Boom. So she is going to head on back to the locker room.
Well, she made all of those seven count, John. And that's a tough out for Veloce Villain. But she is content right now to let this thing roll. But seven additional penalties are going to be called. We have foul out. Little Loca for Suburbia, leaving the track with a smile on her face, but Tucson on a run of their own. This is Pixie Axe on a third scoring pass, and Veloce Villain still not through the pack. Good defensive work now by Rogue Pirogue, taking a little bit of time off the clock as Pixie Axe continues this scoring run, and this will be helpful for at least point differential purposes, but the period clock has expired. There's 35 seconds left on the jam clock, and Tucson on 148, Suburbia on 206.
And another pass there by Pixie Axe. They're finishing very strong. Veloce Villain, after she got knocked out there at turn four, has been taking it pretty easy. Now she did a little cross-check attempt there, but more of a feint than anything else.
And Pixie Axe gets through for five more. 8 seconds left. I don't believe she has 50 points in her arsenal with one more second to go. But Pixie Axe running it out for Tucson, and certainly, again, ending making the point differential a little more acceptable for the ladies from Arizona.
Yeah, that was a very interesting last jam there. Slowing down a bit, Veloce Villain decided after she got knocked out to just kind of take it easy. She's got another game going on today, and possibly two more games, actually, as Suburbia goes on to take on Brandywine tonight at 8. And then hopefully they'll be going to play tomorrow at 2 for 5th or 6th place. But that'll be the final score. Suburbia 206 to Tucson 159.
There you see Veloce Villain and teammates Rogue Pirogue getting some love from the Tucson skaters. Well deserved. These two teams may not have played before today, but they are going to go home with some respect for each other. No doubt about that. Coming up on WFTDA TV in 30 minutes, you are going to be treated to the number one seed, St. Chuck's versus Sin City. We want to thank you for tuning in to WFTDA TV. John Maddening, anything for the good of the order?
Well, just to say that my name's John Madding. We're here with Gretchen the Axe, and you're watching the 2014 Division II playoffs from beautiful Duluth, Minnesota, brought to you by the Harbor City Roller Dames and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. This has been, of course, Tucson versus Suburbia. Final score, Tucson 159, Suburbia 206. Look at these penalties. At the end, Suburbia really called it up, really decided to play a tougher game. And take some more chances, and that's where they got into a little bit of trouble, losing two players at the end, Barry Boom Boom and Little Loca, losing them both in the last jam. Tucson lost one player to an expulsion and had a couple players with six, Pinky McLovin and Blackskin Bomber.
Well, it was a hard-fought game,
no doubt
about it. Lots of big hits. And Barry Boom Boom, as you said, along with Little Loca, they made the most of those penalties. Those were quality penalties, if you will. We're going to wrap it up right now. You are watching WFTDA.tv from the D2 playoffs in Duluth, Minnesota.
Yeah, so tomorrow, as we said, Suburbia takes on Brandywine tonight at 8 p.m. Central Time. Tucson will be playing for ninth place against Omaha tomorrow morning, Sunday morning at 10 a.m., which should actually be a pretty good bout as well. Fantastic work by Tucson for the majority of the game. Suburbia was just able to pull it out at the end. Thank you so much for tuning in to WFTDA.tv. I'm John Madding with Gretchen the Axe, and we will see you very soon.
Smells something awful.
We've been meaning to talk to you about that.
What? Notorious Gear Deodorant. It's not us, it's you.
Please tell me that was you.
What? Notorious Gear Deodorant. Smell the magic.
WFTDA.tv.